So you're thinking about moving to Dallas?
Thinking about it?
Or you wouldn't be here.
I hope you're not just randomly clicking on... Actually, I hope you are just randomly clicking just on our videos.
You're like, look at these guys. Their thumbnails are awesome.
Let's role play for a minute and say you are thinking of moving to Dallas. What are the steps that you need to take when moving to Dallas?
I know the first one, Brian.
What's the first one?
You need to call us.
Call us, dog!
First! Call us first.
Yeah. We're the experts around here. Give us a call. Information's always in the description. Call us, email us, Facebook, carrier pigeons. We do it all. Step one, get the right professionals on your team and call the people that know what they're doing. Call the experts and we'll take care of you. Step one, done.
What are the hardest things about relocating from any place is just getting a lay of the land.
I think
right?
That's huge.
And we're such a sprawling metropolis here in DFW that I will say out of probably the 30 people a year that I help relocate to DFW, 29 of them have no frame of reference where anything is. And it's important to know that we measure distance here in time, not miles.
We do measure distance in time, not miles.
So that's another thing to get acclimated to. And it's one of the questions I always ask people, and I think they should ask themselves is, time-wise,
yes,
how much of a drive can you stomach to the epicenter of your life?
I think that's one of that is really important.
Yeah.
And I think kind of going back to what you said before, like we are so diverse as far as neighborhoods go. And I think that's something maybe people that have never visited here or don't spend a lot of time here, maybe they miss because the notoriety of Dallas is not on the level of like a Chicago or New York or LA. So people might just think Dallas is Dallas. Dallas is like 100 neighborhoods.
Oh, God.
You know?
So many. There's like five of them that just start with letters.
Yeah.
M streets, L streets,
yeah,
C streets.
Exactly, right? I would say, I mean, just people that live here don't even know all the different areas and neighborhoods. So finding the right neighborhood for you, for your lifestyle, for what you're looking for is, I think, number two. That's huge.
Absolutely.
You know, and we actually did some of the work for you. So click up here. Our best, it might be over here. I'm getting used to putting both hands up.
That's the way to do it.
I know I'm touching it, right? We had a best neighborhoods in Dallas video. So we covered that a little bit. So make sure you check that out. We go into kind of detail on the different neighborhoods of Dallas and in the different areas and what they're all about. Find the right place for you. I think that's step number two, right?
Absolutely. And you were talking about earlier getting the right team. Part of having the right team isn't just calling Brian and I, right? There's a whole litany of things that you have to do prior to getting the financing side figured out, all of that stuff. And we have all of those people in place very easily and readily available for people exactly like yourselves who are moving in from long distances or out of state. Or say you're local and you're just watching this and you just want to learn more about Dallas. We can help you there too.
Yep. Lenders, inspectors, insurance, title companies, all those things are really important. I would say just very specifically, one of the things that people that relocate from another state have a tendency to do sometimes, because a lot of us have our allegiances and different things like that. Lending practices are different in every state,
mm-hmm,
right? And so that's something where you can have a little bit of some shock, you know, and maybe some things that come up that are unexpected if you're using a lender from your home state but buying a house in another state. I would say to avoid any possible consequences or obstacles or hiccups along the way, try and work with a vendor that obviously knows the area, is local, and I would say has a really good synergy with the real estate expert you're using too. I would say 99% of real estate transactions that do go sideways, which doesn't happen a lot when you're working with great people, but if they ever do, it's because there's some sort of disconnect between different vending partners and the people that are supposed to be working towards a common goal. Working with people that work together all the time is a surefire way to make sure that you're going to foresee any obstacles ahead of time and overcome them with ease.
Well, and what you and I know, and people who have bought a few houses maybe hopefully have not experienced it, but if you've ever been part of a real estate transaction that's gotten squirrely, it is imperative communication between all parties.
Yes.
Is typically what keeps, I'll tell you right now, right, we're sitting here, I just have 10 deals on the board recently. We're down to three now because they've been closing.
Sure.
But when there were 10, there were four of them actively blowing up.
Yeah.
They only stayed together because all of the people involved were highly communicative and we were working towards a solution
the
entire
time.
Yeah,
and they were communicative because they work together all the time and they just knock stuff out when it comes up. So that's huge.
Don't ever underestimate the value of having people local or getting caught up in the marketing of a large nationwide company.
Yes.
Right? Because I think that's, on the lending side, that's the biggest mistake people make.
Sure. Sure.
Reach out to us. We have more than one option. We can put you in contact with a person who's going to best fit your needs. There's no doubt about that.
100%. Then what you got to do? Find the right house, I would assume?
Yeah. I mean, look, that's going to go all the way back to what you were talking about with the neighborhood thing.
Sure.
That's going to be an exploratory process. And we have awesome tools to help you out with that. If you can't make it here physically,
yep.
Video is something we use at a super high level for all of our clients.
Yep.
There's so much stuff that we can do to help you explore neighborhoods prior to even coming to town. And then, of course, when you get here or if you're coming to town on limited time, we have the resources to make sure that we're available for you
yep.
and can carve out that time to take the biggest, the most advantage of the little bit of time you have in town.
That's huge, being able to hit the ground running, being
Absolutely.
Able to at least, I would say whenever we're showing houses, especially to people that are from out of state, it could be really, really, enticing to just see things online and be like, I want to see that in person, that in person, that for that, you know, and then you come in for a weekend and you've got 40 houses that you really want to check out. There's no way you're ever going to be able to knock all those out. Rely on a team that's got a lot of leverage, that's got a lot of things in place, so we can go and do video tours of them in advance, kind of get more details in advance. You'd be amazed at how many things you're just going to be able to knock off your list because they're not perfect for you for one reason or another, and only one house can be the winner usually. You can get rid of a lot of the stuff that's just going to be kind of spinning your tires so that you can maximize your time when you're here and really only be looking at the A-plus ones on your list.
Yep.
Ultimately, you're probably going to choose one of the A-plus ones on your list anyway, so let us do some of the legwork and get the other ones that are kind of maybes. Dive deeper on those so you can make a decision one way or another and maximize your time. That's huge.
Absolutely.
You know,
and look, I think the last thing you need to do, if you didn't do it the first time and you're at this point in the process now, you need to go all the way back to step one and call us.
Step one, step five, or whatever that last step
was. However many steps there were.
If you're 6.5 minutes into this video and you haven't realized that you need to call us, we're going to tell you again.
We got our number plastered everywhere
yep.
in the comments and descriptions of this dang thing.
So 100%. We appreciate you guys hanging with us. Work with the best, man. We'll take care of you. If you are thinking about relocating to North Texas, we're your guys. Our information is always in the description and probably a whole bunch of places in this video. So we'd love to talk with you, be of service any way that we possibly can.
Yep.
So.
Giddy up. Come on to Texas.
I'm going to end it on
See
that.
You soon.
I love it. Bye.
Bye.